In this video, we will be covering the password protection system. We will learn all about simple password protecting media players and playlists with quick single passwords. Creating password packages to which you can add one or multiple password groups. Setting password packages to single media players as well as playlists. Managing and exporting your passwords with the password management system. To set a single simple password, you will need to select the media you wish to password protect from the central media management panel. With the chosen media selected, click on the Access tab in the lower settings panel. Under password protection, click on the drop-down menu and select Simple Password. You will be presented with a Passwords field where you can enter the password you would like to use to access the media. After entering your desired password, simply click on the Save button to save your changes. Your single media is now set to be password protected and will only play with your chosen password. You can change your simple password for a media player or playlist player. Simply select the media you wish to change from the central media management panel. With the chosen media selected, click on the Access Control tab in the lower settings panel. Under Password field, simply overwrite the current password to your new one. Click on the Save button to save your changes. The previously active password will now no longer be able to access the media player and can only be accessed with a newly set password. If you no longer wish to use the simple password, you can select the media from the central media management panel you wish to set back to free to watch. With the chosen media selected, click on the Access Control tab in the lower settings panel. Under Password Protection, click on the drop-down menu and select Access Without Password. Now, simply click on the Save button to save your changes. Your media player will now no longer require a password to be viewed. By creating a password package, you can add password groups that can be added to single media players as well as playlists, locking them down to be only accessible with the passwords associated to the package applied. To create your password packages, you will need to go to Settings, Access Control, Password Protection. Here you will see a list of the current password packages as well as the default Access Without Password package. To create your new password package, you will need to click on the New Package button. Now, in the Password Package Setup panel, give your password package a name. Select when you wish to show the password world to the viewer. You can set this to be immediately, which will bring up the password request as soon as the viewer presses the play button on the player. You can also choose to set this with delay. Here you can enter the amount of seconds of free viewing time before the password world will be displayed to the viewer after they press the play button. To save your password package, simply click on the green Save button below. With your password package created, you're now able to add password groups to it. Now that you have created a password package, you can add one or multiple password groups to the password package. Each password group can have different variables such as expiry period, as well as amount of allowed views and if it's valid for one or multiple videos. You could simply add one password group with a single set of parameters. Or you could add multiple groups with different parameters. To create a password group, click on the large Add Password Group button to create a new group. On the right-hand configuration panel, you will now be able to select your chosen configurations for the password group. Under Password Group Name, you will need to enter the name to give to your password group. The password generator is used to set the password parameters as well as generating your desired passwords. Under Expiry Period, you can choose to limit the amount of time with which the password is able to access the media. When set to unlimited, the ticket will not expire. You can enter a set amount of days, weeks, months, years from the generation date at which the password will expire. Under Total Views, you can set a number for the total amount of views allowed across all connected videos to this password. For example, you may set this to 10 views in total across a playlist with multiple videos. Under Max Views per Video, you can set a maximum amount of views number for each individual video. For example, you may set this to 5 views per video. In a playlist with multiple videos, each video would then only be able to be watched a total of 5 times for each video within the playlist. Tags are to help you identify the tickets internally at a later stage. You can enter as many tags as you wish, and you can also comma separate them to add multiple. We have 2 password generation methods available. Random generates a chosen amount of random passwords by entering your desired amount of passwords. Click on the green Save button below to save your ticket group and generate the random passwords. You could also set your generation method to custom and enter a single password you would like your viewers to use to gain access. Under existing passwords, you will see any previously generated or saved passwords. You have now created a password group and added it to your password package. You can now set your single media players as well as playlist players to be password protected with your newly created password package. You can add previously created password groups to new and existing password packages. For example, if you have created password group 1 in password package 1, then reuse group 1 in password package 2, all players that have package 1 or 2 applied will be accessible with the password generated in group 1, as both password packages have group 1 associated to them. If you make any changes to password group 1, all changes will be applied to any password package that uses password group 1. To add an existing password group, create a new password package. Now, with the new password package created, select the existing password group section from the right-hand configuration panel. With the existing password group section expanded, you will see any previously created groups. Simply click on your desired group to add it to the current password package. To save your password group and your password package, simply click on the green Save button below. Once you have created a custom pay-per-view package, you can set your chosen media such as videos, live events, web TV players, IP cameras or even audio files to be password protected. In this section, we will be setting individual media files to be password protected. To set a password package to individual videos, you would simply go to your media section. Select the video you would like to be password protected. With the video selected, click on the Access Control tab in the video settings bar. Here, under Password Protection, you can simply select your desired password package from the drop-down menu. Save your changes by clicking on the green Save button. You have now set your chosen media to be password protected. You can restrict an entire playlist to your preferred password package. This will make all the media files within the playlist require a password from your chosen password package. To set all media files within a playlist to be password protected, simply click onto the Playlist button in your Media section. Select a playlist you would like to be password protected. With the playlist selected, click on the Access Control tab in the Settings bar. Under Password Protection, you can simply select your desired password package from the drop-down menu. Save your changes by clicking on the green Save button. This will open a pop-up information box asking if you would like to change the current default package to your newly chosen password package. In the pop-up, you get the opportunity to revise any affected media by clicking on the summary buttons. Select the media you wish to apply to your new package by selecting the checkmark next to it. Simply click on the green Confirm button to apply your desired changes. You have now applied your chosen password package to your desired playlist. By default, all videos and playlists are set to be accessed without passwords. You can change this by going to Settings, Access Control, Password Protection. Here you will see a list of your current password packages as well as the default Access Without Password package. The default Home icon allows you to change the default password package applied to all videos and playlists. The Home icon next to the package name indicates which package is currently active as the global default package. To change your current global default access setting for your media to a password package, hover over your desired package's name and click on the home icon next to the desired package. You will be presented with a pop-up information box asking if you want to change the current default package to the newly chosen one. You also get the opportunity to revise any affected media by clicking on the summary buttons. Select the media to which you wish to apply the new package by selecting the checkmark next to it. Simply click on the green Confirm button to apply any desired changes. You have now changed the default access for your media to your desired custom passwords package. With the password management system, you can disable and enable passwords that you have previously created, as well as editing password attributes such as expiry dates, total allowed views, and allowed views per video, and adding tags to easily identify passwords. You can even export passwords to .csv or XML. To manage your created passwords, you will need to go to the Settings tab. Here, under Setup, you will find the Access Control menu. Click on it to expand the subsections and select the Password Management tab, which will display all your currently created passwords in the center. The information displayed in the center column for each password includes creation date, which is the date the password was created, password, which is the currently active password group, which shows you to which password group the password relates to, expiry date is when the passwords will expire, allowed views is the total amount of allowed views across all media, allowed views per video is the total amount of allowed views per video. Plays shows you how many times the media has been played with the password. Next to each password, you will see three icons in the Options column. The checkmark and cross icons allow you to enable or disable passwords. When a password has been disabled, any related media will no longer be able to be accessed. The graph icon will take you to the detailed password analytics for the currently selected password. You can delete the current password by clicking on the Delete icon. The deleted password will stop functioning and any related media will not be accessible with the deleted password. To edit a password's expiry parameters, please select the password you wish to edit from the Passwords Management panel. On the right-hand editing panel, you will be able to change and update its expiry parameters. Under Expiry Period, you can choose to limit the amount of time with which a password is able to access the media. You can either set it to unlimited or specify an expiration date. Under Total Allowed Views, you can set a number for the total amount of views allowed across all connected videos to this password. For example, you may set this to 10 views in total across a playlist with multiple videos. Under Total Allowed Views per video, you can set the maximum amount of times each video can be viewed. For example, you may set this to 5 views per video. In a playlist with multiple videos, each video would then only be able to be watched a total of 5 times for each video within the playlist. Tags are to help you identify the tickets internally at a later stage. You can enter as many tags as you want by comma separating them. Please click on the Update button to save any changes made to your password expiry parameters. To export all passwords to a .csv spreadsheet file, simply click on the Export Passwords to .csv button, located at the top right-hand side within the Password Management panel. You can also copy a XML export link by clicking on the Copy XML Export Link button. This completes our guided tour of the password system. You can check out more detailed information and tutorials in our help pages at help.streamingvideoprovider.com.